Have you been witnessing shoulder pain because of a recently played sport? In this video, I am going to discuss about the causes and symptoms of shoulder joint. Hi, I'm Dr. Sudarshan, founder of Joints in Motion, and welcome to my series, The Shoulder Joint. So let us understand what really causes a shoulder pain. Most of the common cause of shoulder pain is a poor posture, like a forward head where you know the shoulder is completely rounded, where you can actually witness a lot of shoulder pain or even difficulty while lifting the shoulder. Second common cause is a muscle injury which can happen because of while playing sport or while lifting weights. Very common is while you are actually lifting heavy weights in the gym. Most of the times it also happens when you have an arthritic shoulder, which is normally in the old age. A lot of times heart attacks also mimic shoulder pain, which is essentially on the left side of your shoulder. So you need to understand that this is an urgent situation. Another reason for a shoulder joint pain could be a fracture of clavicle, or for that matter even a fracture of the shoulder. One more reason could be a nerve pinch, which happens normally around the shoulder joint. Now these different problems actually lead to frozen shoulder, where after a certain span of time your shoulder movements stops or there is restriction in the shoulder movements. So let us now understand the symptoms, or how does it feel when your shoulder pains. So typically the pain is on the front side of the shoulder. This is the area which will normally tend to have a pain. A specific point is something which can be painful. Sometimes it is also the sides which are painful. Difficulty while sleeping onto the same side, whichever is painful, can be noticed. Eventually this leads to a little bit of weakening, where reaching out to certain activities becomes a little difficult. You find it difficult to reach out or pull out or to a certain activity. Gradually there is a restriction in the range of motion, where you will feel the inability to move the shoulder beyond a certain point. Like this movement can be a little difficult. Reaching out towards to the back can be a little difficult. Now these are the times where you need to understand that your shoulder is a little difficult to manage and it needs attention. At times you may also come up with a situation where doing a particular activity may not give you any pain, but after that activity is done you may start feeling a numbness or sudden kind of pain, maybe at night or after the end of the activity. Well, this is also a situation where you may need therapy. Secondly, there is something called a painful arc syndrome, wherein you will find typically when your shoulder is moving, it is okay to move in a certain range, but after a certain point it becomes difficult for you to move till then, and then after that again it's absolutely fine. So this is something where your range is restricted and painful only on a certain arc. This is called a painful arc syndrome. Probably the consistent pain may not be there, but only while lifting, when I'm lifting my shoulder from here, ouch, this is where I can feel the pain, and this goes ow, and here, right now, this is still okay. So it doesn't mean that your restriction, there is no restriction in the range. It also means that there is a painful arc which is developed. So today we discussed the causes and symptoms of shoulder pain. In my next video, I will talk to you about certain tips about how to avoid shoulder injuries, and most importantly, how do we treat shoulder injuries. But before that, don't forget to like and subscribe our YouTube channel, and make sure you keep putting up your questions. Thank you.